Alright, so you can also lift it up from here. This is a 2016 Toyota Corolla. And today we're going to replace the wheel studs, drum brake wheel studs. You can see they're broken off. There's only two wheel nuts left. Just pulling the wheel. So we're going to remove the two. And we'll see what happens. Grab the rocket mallet you have there, big one. Give it a big whack. Play around with it. Just like so. Okay, now to remove the studs, you want to have this tool, so you want to have the biggest hammer you'll have in your hand, and we'll just pop it out. Make sure that you have it lined up in this opening, because there's a lot of clearance back there. If you're going to have it here, you're going to end up hitting the brake mechanisms. Okay, so you want to have it right here or here, so along this area here, along this area is where you want to have the studs and things, just like so. In this case, you only want to just give it a pat, tap it right there. See, it hasn't come out all the way out yet. Ow, careful. Don't hit it too hard. It's a light, medium tap, I guess, just to drive it out. So we have got all the studs out. Now, I'm going to show you guys how to install the new one. We got doorman here. This is the wheel stud. Part number 610-2661. Alright, that's the wheel stud. And again, this is the wheel nut. Part 611-1331. Okay, so I'm gonna replace all five stud and five nuts together. Okay guys, so we have these studs. So you basically wanna slide it from the back and grab your finger to the other side and direct it through the hole. And yeah, that should just go in like so. What you want to do is you want to grab, so this is the tool that you're going to use. You're also going to need an open ended nuts for the stud, right? So that's an open ended stud. So you're going to have this nut. I'm gonna have it put in that way, and I'm gonna have this open-ended nut to go in. All right So that's how it goes. So this is basically just the washer, big enough to go in through. See, it doesn't thread in, right? And then you want to have the open-ended nut so we can put it back in. All right, so let's do this. So I'm gonna put this in first. Make sure that the stud is lined up straight. And then I'm just gonna use my air tools to zap it in. And with your hand holding on to the that's where I am. Alright. So I'm gonna start again. I'm gonna do it again until it drives all the way in flush to this. So I'm almost in there. Just need a couple more punched in there. And then that will go and it will be flush. Be flush to the hub, alright? Alright, here we go for the third time again. Alright, so that's what it would look like. There you go, that's flush. That's as flush as I can get. You want to do that on all five studs. Alright. Again, you slide it in, have your other finger direct it into the hole, make sure that's straight. And to remove this, just want to undo the... Same way that we did the other one earlier. Okay, that looks like it's straight. Go a little bit more. Thank you. Alright, so here is the result, guys. So I've got all five of the studs replaced, put in new. And we're gonna go through every one of them to see if there's any gap. There's no gap there. It's flush, 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 flush. Alright, so this job is all done, guys. Thanks for watching.